It would take Evelyn 3 days to paint a house, and it would take Lauren 5 days to paint the same house. How long would it take to paint the house if Evelyn and Lauren worked together? Sometimes we're tempted to take the average of the days, or the times, for each of these, but that will not work. If we took the average of 5 and 3 days, we'd get 4 days, and that's more than Evelyn just working by herself, so certainly it is not the average of the two times. But we do have a process for dealing with these work problems. You may remember this distance equals rate times time formula. Well, we can do something similar with the amount of work. So I'll write the amount of work. So instead of a distance traveled, you have amount of work. And that also equals rate times time. So looking at each of these girls individually, let's look at Evelyn's situation. Or I'll say Evelyn's work. Evelyn's work will be equal to her rate multiplied by her time. So, quickly setting up a little chart here, I have Evelyn's rate as 1/3 of a house per day. Why is that? Well, it takes her 3 days to paint a house, so every day that she would be painting, she would paint 1/3 of the house. And then after 2 days, she'd have 2/3 done, and after 3 days, she'd have 3/3 or the full house. So we have 1/3 of a house per day. Times, we don't know how long she's going to be working, because this is going to be the situation for Evelyn and Lauren working together. But Evelyn's work, then, is this amount. Let's take a look at Lauren's situation. Lauren's work that equals Lauren's rate times her time. Well, Lauren's rate is not 5, but 1/5. If it takes her 5 days, then she finishes 1/5 of a house per day. That's her rate. Her time is going to be the same as Evelyn's, because again, this is when the girls are working together. Worked together. Okay, so we've got Evelyn's work and Lauren's work. So if I just paraphrase right here and say Evelyn's work plus Lauren's work will equal one house. I'll write it out there. Will equal one house. So if I add these two, if I add 1/3 of times t plus 1/5 times t, we should get one house. Okay, let's get rid of these fractions. And the way you can get rid of the fractions is to multiply through by the lowest common denominator. The lowest common denominator of 3 and 5 would be 15. So I'm going to multiply everything by 15. I'll put it over here. Okay, everything. So multiplying this and this and the 1. Everything is being multiplied by 15. Okay, 1/3, let's see, I'm going to put a few arrows here so I can fit this in. 1/3 times 15 is 5. 1/3 of 15 is 5. So I have 5t plus 1/5 of 15 is 3. So 3t equals, remember we're multiplying everything by 15, so equals 15. So quickly, 8t equals 15, and t, our time, equals 15/8. Or in other words, let's switch to another color here. It would take 1 7/8 days. Almost 2 days to complete the one house if Evelyn and Lauren were working together.